Hi there, folks. So someone recently asked us in Red Giant social channel about Magic Bullet Looks, wondering how to use Magic Bullet Looks in an ACES Color Management workflow when grading. Well, my friend, I'm glad that you asked, because using Magic Bullet Looks is very straightforward. I'll show you three different flavors. First, we'll explore Resolve and see how you can use Magic Bullet Looks in a full ACES setup. And then we transition into Premiere Pro and see how you can also use Magic Bullet Looks there. And finally, we'll head to After Effects and see how you can use Magic Bullet Looks in your ACES compositing setup. Ready? So let's dive in. So here we are in DaVinci Resolve. First, we'll need to set up our ACES project. Go to the project settings by clicking the gear icon or pressing Shift 9. Once you're there, open the Color Management tab and choose ACES CCT or ACES CC as your color science. There are differences between these two, but ACES CCT is a newer and more improved version of ACES CC, which is being slowly phased out. Select your ACES versions, and I recommend to always choosing the newest version. In this case, we'll use ACES 1.3. Leave your ACES input transform to no input transform, especially if you have more than one type file format when working within ACES. ACES is smart enough to recognize file formats that carry camera metadata like RAW files. So if you're working with RAW files, by leaving this field to no input transform, ACES will tag and display those files correctly for you. Next, we can leave ACES reference gamut compress checked and select our ACES output transform. So when delivering your content to computer screens and TVs, you can safely choose Rec. 709. I'll select Rec. 709 for this example. Finally, let's check the Use Color Space Aware Grading Tool checkbox. We'll talk more about this in a future video. Now we're pretty much done setting up ACES in DaVinci Resolve. Here, I have two different log clips which still appear as flat. This is because we left ACES input transform field set to no input transform. And these log files also don't carry camera metadata, so we'll need to tag them separately. Right-click on the thumbnail and select the file type accordingly. Here we have a clip shot in Sony S gamut with S-Log3, and the next file was shot in Canon C70 in Canon Cinema gamut with C-Log2 curve. By tagging the correct input transform, our clips are now displayed correctly, nice and crisp. Now, in order to use Magic Bullet Looks, you can simply type in Looks on the OFX panel and drag and drop Looks to the empty node. Click Edit to launch the Looks Designer window. Now, the image doesn't appear right. That's because we simply need to inform Looks that we are in ACES CCT. Click the drop-down arrow from the in-out color space and select ACES CCT. Now we get the correct image from here on. You can now develop your look using all the tools inside Magic Bullet Looks, or simply select the available presets, like this film emulation one. Once you confirm your look, the designer window will be closed and will be back in Resolve again. If you apply looks at the clip level, then looks will only be applied to this particular clip. However, when we apply looks at the timeline level, all the clips in the project will have the same look. Now let's take a look at Magic Bullet Looks in Premiere Pro. Here in Premiere Pro, things are handled a little bit differently, since by the time I'm making this video, there is still no native support for ACES within the app. But don't worry, you can still use ACES Transform within Magic Bullet Looks. Drag and drop looks from your effects panel and hit Edit. In the In-Out Color Space drop-down arrow, you can select Custom. Once the Custom mode is selected, you'll have a full access to the color management within Magic Bullet Looks. Leave the mode to Open Color I/O ACES and select Input. Here, we have a clip that is coming from a Canon camera. So let's select Input, Canon, Canon Log 2 Cinema Gamut Daylight. Uncheck the Same as Input button because we want our output to be in our display color space. In this case, Rec. 709 is already selected, and my targeted display is happened to be Rec. 709 as well. If I want to target a P3 display, for example, I can also change it here. There is also this preview button on the top of the screen. Here, we are targeting a Rec. 709 display, so we can leave the preview to Rec. 709. But you can also preview it in sRGB or other display space if you want to. But for simplicity, let's leave it in Rec. 709 for now. Now we're pretty much done, and now you can create your look using all the available tool or start with an available presets. Let's use the same film grade presets again, and let's confirm our look. Now we can copy and paste looks onto the second clip. Here, since the clip was shot with Sony camera and the other clip was shot with Canon, we need to change the input for this one. Launch Magic Bullet Looks once again and change the input to Input, Sony, S-Log3, S-Gamut3.cine, and hit Confirm. Now, if we compare both of the clips, there are still differences, and this is due to the onset lighting and exposure. This can easily be fixed by using Colorista. Here, I'm using Colorista to match my first clip to the second clip. I'll drag and drop Colorista right before it looks, and we can also enable the comparison view, and here, I'm setting the second clip as the reference clip. Now let's set the Colorista control response to lock, and let's quickly analyze the clip. We need to see that there is a lighting difference between these two clips. In this reference clip, Sammy, the subject, was in the shadow, while in the clip I am tweaking, the sun is shining onto Sammy's face, so we won't be matching Sammy one-to-one, but we will need to tweak the look and feel to be close to one another. This is a concern that we can always keep in our mind while matching. So here, I'll quickly play around with the amount of tint. I can also adjust the amount of highlight and also the amount of mid-tone. I will also adjust the highlight regions. So this is just a quick matching, and we can always go into more detail about matching clips in the future videos. Let me know in the comments if you want to see it. Now, one thing that you want to consider when in Premiere Pro is that you can use looks right away at the clip level, or if you have multiple clips coming from the same camera, then you can also use the same Magic Bullet looks in an adjustment layer. Alright then, now let's move on to After Effects. In After Effects, you can set ACES in the project settings. In your comp, click the 32 BPC icon to open the project settings. Go to Color and change the color engine to OCIO Color Manage. You'll get a pop-up notifications, but just hit OK and we can continue. Now let's set the OCIO configurations. And like before, I will go with the newer versions and choose ACES 1.3 Studio versions 1.0. Make sure the bit depth is set to 32 bits per channel. 3D LUT interpolations to tetrahedral. This is necessary when you're working with LUTs. Tetrahedral provides a better interpolations than trilinear. Now, we can set the working color space to be in Scene Linear ACES CG. By the way, if you cannot find this option, make sure to check the Show All checkbox. Now set the display color space to the same display you are targeting for your delivery or the display that you are using. In my case, I am using a Rec. 709 display, so sRGB-display would be fine. But if you want to target Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4, then choose Rec. 1886 Rec. 709 Display ACES 1.0 SDR Video. Yes, I know it's a bit a mouthful descriptions, but since we like details, that's okay. That's great. Now, as you can see, our clip is even flatter than before. But that is just because we haven't informed the ACES framework what type of clip we are using. So let's do that. Select the clip we are using and open the interpret footage, then select color. Make sure that the show all checkbox is selected. Now, open the drop-down arrow and select the correct tag. We know that this clip is coming from a Sony camera, so we'll select input, Sony, S-Log3, S-Gamma3 Cine, and hit OK. Now we're pretty much done setting ACES. We've selected the correct display output, we've selected the working space, and we've tagged the correct input for our clip. Now let's drag and drop Magic Bullet looks from the effects panel. Now as you hit edit, you'll see that you're seeing a correct image right away inside Magic Bullet looks. This is because Magic Bullet looks and After Effects are communicating with each other, and Magic Bullet looks is using the project settings from After Effects. As you can see in In-Out Color Space, the option reads Project ACES CG. So when you're using Magic Bullet looks in ACES inside After Effects, you don't have to do anything. That's great, isn't it? Now you can do fun stuff in looks and create the look that you're after. So, folks, those are some methods of how you can incorporate Magic Bullet looks within ACES framework. Hopefully that helps, and if you have any questions, please feel free to let me know in the comments. This is Max for Maxon Color. Happy grading with Magic Bullet looks.